and that's what Vivian Foley does. She's a canal artist. She and her husband own two of London's best-known longboats, Jason and Serpens. They take people up and down the Regent's Park Canal. So I suppose, really, you've had to become a bit of an artist to look after those two boats.
There's always a lot of painting to be done around the boats.
But it is very much a traditional craft, isn't it, with some very set rules?
Yes, in fact, it's one of the few remaining folk arts in the country. And although there's several different ways of painting roses, the colours are always the same.
Let's have a look at some of the things that you brought up from Jason, because you brought up some things to illustrate the very traditional ideas behind the art. Yes. For instance, there are very set subjects, like roses. What else?
There are roses and castles and geometric designs.
Why do you think that there are just those few things?
Well, nobody really seems to know, but I think people generally think that the castles fulfill the boatman's dreams of a larger place to live in, and the castles because the roses because they had no gardens.
No, he wanted his little patch somewhere or other.
Right.
Yeah. What? Okay, so you've got very traditional and set subjects. What about colours?
The colours are usually the same. The roses are yellow, white, and red.
Let's have a look here. We've got a barrel with a rose design, and we've also got these kitchen spoons that look very simple, actually.
Yes,
I should think a lot of our people watching could have a go at painting something like that. And there's a tray here, all with the same rose design.
Yes.
And that goes on the outside of longboats as well.
Yes, it does.
And this is the panels that you're doing here are for the outside of
the on the outside of the cabin and also on the cabin doors.
Well, I hope I'm not ruining my panel too much, but just show us how you build the design up.
Yes, I've broken it into three different stages. The first one, it's very simple. You just do round blobs of colour for the centres of the roses.
Yeah.
Fill in with green for the leaves.
That's what I'm attempting now.
Yes. And then a blue blob for daisies that are in among the leaves.
Yeah. That brings us on to the middle one.
The middle stage is the nicest. It's where we do the petals, and that's where the flowers really come to life.
Mm.
And the last stage here, you just paint on the petals for the daisies and do yellow flashes on the leaves.
Well, that's really very pretty.
And stamens also, I forgot that.
It's really smashing, and we'll have to take a closer look at longboats now. Every time I see one, I'll look for these designs. Right, I'll get on with this now. Right. Under your supervision, right here in this very studio, before your very eyes, because we've got the most magnificent model of a working pound lock here in the studio. And if you can hear an engine chugging away in the background, well, that's essential to keep the water circulating. If we didn't have it, we'd probably all get flooded, so I have to put up with the noise. Now then, HMS Murgatroyd. Chug, 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 up here, into the pound, and then I can close up the gates at this end, the mitre gates. Make sure that the sluices or paddles are closed there. Open up the sluices or paddles of the other gate, and immediately the water level starts to drop as the water flows out, and I've just moored my little boat up here. These pound locks were first introduced on the Exeter Canal in 1564. They were originated by a Chinaman called Chiao Wei Yo way back in 983 when he was working on the Grand Canal in China. And now I think our lock's pretty well ready for me to open the gates. So we've successfully brought HMS Murgatroyd downhill, which is one of the purposes of a lock after all, taking boats up and down on our waterways. So I can moor you HMS Murgatroyd there, chug, chug, chug. What a marvellous toy. I think everyone should have one of those in their bathroom. Back to Jenny and Doug doing the real thing.
Once we'd actually got the boat through the top gate, we had to make it secure.
I'll grab the back of it. Now we gate.
Easier said than done, especially as old Caleb, the lock keeper, was keeping a watchful eye on our efforts.
It's quite heavy, isn't it?
Yes.
Hugh wasn't kidding, for that solid oak lock gate must have weighed about 2 tons. But then he gave me a tip. He told me to go around to the other side of the beam and to push it with my bottom. And soon the gate started to move, for in fact, the weight of the gate is balanced by the weight of the beam. Very crafty.
With the top gate firmly shut, I had to open the paddles on the bottom one with a thing called a windlass.
Is this the thing, Hugh?
That's right, wind it up. I'll put some muscle into it.
As the paddle came up, the water started to flow out of the lock. About 56,000 gallons of it, in fact. And then I had to cross back over the lock gate to open up the other paddle. Well, at least I was getting some exercise.
Ooh. But it's already quite peaceful going down. It's when you're going up in the lock that the trouble starts and the water rushes in.
Should I just push us away from it?
Yes, give us a shove off from the gate.
As the water emptied out, the parry two settled down into the lock. When the water had leveled, Jenny, with her newfound muscles, opened the bottom gate. Or tried to.
I've got my back in it.
Oh. Bit more.
It seemed impossible, but one hefty push and at last the gate started to swing open, slowly. But it did gain weight quite quickly, and in fact, I very nearly fell in.
Wait for the bump. Can you come down and get on the boat, Jenny? Quickly, you'll miss it.
OK.
Come on, hurry up.
That's what these steps are for.
Well done.
Welcome aboard.
Feeling as if we'd really accomplished something, we were only to be informed by Hugh that there were another five locks to go through, making up the Hanwall flight and lowering the canal by 50 feet to bring it to the same level as the Thames. That Hugh's full of little surprises.
We should have been grateful there were only five, because at Tardybig near Birmingham there's a flight of 30 locks lifting the canal by 217 feet. But five or 30, it's all hard work. For some.